Hello friends and welcome to this video. In the chapter 7 titled as Wavelet Transform to Learn Advanced Digital Signal Processing, the understanding of how the wavelet family, a mathematical tool family to address the various applications of signal processing domain we have seen. It was a journey, right? Wavelet from Morlet to Daubechies via Mallard. Also, we have seen this understanding with the help of a comparison to the earlier popular mathematical tools from the Fourier family, and it was a focused geometrical point of view here. Now we are well aware with the continuous wavelet transform, for which we know the time frequency tiling benefit as compared to the earlier tool, and we have also seen the brief properties of the wavelets of continuous wavelet transform. So it is time to have a focus on more practical and easy to implement form of the wavelet transform tool, which is discrete wavelet transform. So as earlier we are covered with the understanding of the continuous wavelet transform, we will try to have define of the discrete wavelet transform with little bit of the modifications from the current form that we have seen for CWT, continuous wavelet transform. That is why we are going to address the topic that is titled continuous versus discrete wavelet transform. So let us begin with the topic. So here we can start with our topic, the topic titled continuous versus discrete wavelet transformation here. So for continuous wavelet transform, we have already seen the mathematical representation here. So as we know that the continuous wavelet transform, what we can abbreviate to as CWT, it is basically a function of the two parameters, and therefore it contains a high amount of the redundant information when analyzing a particular function. So instead of having the continuous varying of the parameters and storing that much of the information with the help of this particular tool, if we analyze the signal with a little bit small number of scales with varying the number of translations at this particular scale, so it will be nothing but the practical form, which is discrete wavelet transformation here. So this is really most demanded topic for understanding here. So this way we can have a change from continuous domain wavelet transformation to the discrete domain wavelet transform representation here. So as we can see that the discrete wavelet transform can be, in another words, be derived from this continuous wavelet transform, or the explicit representation of the discrete wavelet transformation can also be made without considering what way we have a representation in continuous wavelet transform. Let us have the comparison of CWT and that of the DWT. So we shall be viewing it as a discretization, first of all, discretization of the continuous wavelet transform through the sampling process, which is specific to the wavelet coefficients here. So for exactness of the representation, as we switch from continuous wavelet transform domain to that of the discrete domain, we can call it to be a critical sampling of the continuous wavelet transform representation. Here we can denote it mathematically by W of A comma B, which is equal to the time integral over the functional representation f of t with multiplication to 1 upon square root of mod a into psi of t minus b divided by small a dt here. So this can be obtained by making small a is equal to 2 to the power minus j, where the representations of small j and small k are nothing but the integers, which are the set of discrete translations and the discrete dilations here. So if we have the substitutions to this representation, we get the integral, time integral f of t multiplied to 1 upon square root of mod a with psi of t minus b divided by small a dt, substituted as the time integral f of t 2 to the power j by 2 psi of 2 to the power j t minus k dt here. So this is the function of j and k, and here we can denote it by simply w of j comma k instead of w of a comma b that you have seen in the first equation on the left hand side here. So as we have called the sampling process to be the critical sampling for the exactness that defines the resolution of the discrete wavelet transform in both the time and that of the frequency domain here. Here we are making the use of the term critical for the minimum number of coefficients, in another words I can say, sampled from the continuous wavelet transformation for ensuring all the information present into the original function retained by the wavelet coefficients without any sort of loss here. So let us visualize one illustration that will show us the time frequency scale plane of the wavelet transform here. So here we have this particular illustration, critical sampling of the time frequency plane by discretizing the continuous wavelet transform parameters by small a is equal to 2 to the power minus j as we have discussed, and small b is equal to small k times 2 to the power minus j here. So here in this illustration, the two axes you see with the markings of small a on the vertical axis and small b on the horizontal axis here. So in the case of continuous wavelet transformation, we find the wavelet coefficients for every small a comma b combination here, whereas the difference from this continuous wavelet transform to discrete wavelet transform is that here we are going to find the wavelet coefficients only at very few points denoted by the dots and the wavelets that follow these values given by the mathematical equation. Here we have psi suffix jk of t, which is equal to 2 to the power j by 2 psi of 2j t minus k here. So this is the wavelet for all the integers j and k produced at the orthogonal basis here. In general, if we have the substitution j and k to be equal to 0, 0, so we have psi suffix 0, 0 of t equal to psi of t, and we can call it to be a mother wavelet, and the other wavelets are supposed to be produced by the translation operation and the dilation operation of this mother wavelet here. Here we again visualize the time frequency tiling in the case of discrete wavelet transform here. In the earlier case, when we learned the continuous type of the wavelet transformation, thereupon also we had addressed the tiling of the time frequency here. So here it is for the discrete wavelet transformation. You see the horizontally lying time axis and the vertically lying frequency axis, the different blocks with the different resolutions on the time and the frequency you can see here. So this way, the comparison of the continuous versus the discrete wavelet transform we can have. This is basically a slow shifting from the continuous to the discrete representation here. So in continuation to this regard, by the next lecture we shall be addressing the Haar scaling functions and the functional spaces. Haar wavelet is the basic and simplest to understand that we are going to start a study of. That is why this particular topic. Thank you.